Now I'll show you how to upload the content into your Moodle site. So this is my sample Moodle site which I have created. In some of my previous videos I have shown how to enroll the users and then how to create the new course and all. Please watch my previous videos. Now I'll show you how to add the content into your course. So I'm just going to my course login. So here you can click site home, and then you have this option called human resource analytics. This is my course. You go inside into this course. So this is a faculty window basically. So whenever you want to make any changes here, I mean whenever you want to add anything or delete anything, so always you need to turn on this editing button. So on the right hand side corner you will have the settings button. So you click turn editing on. After that you will be able to get all those options like add an activity or resource and so on. So now this announcement is by default coming. If you want to make any announcements to your students, you can type it here, and then automatically they will get the notification through email, as well as if they go inside into the course in the home page, they will be able to check the announcements. For example, next week I'm going to conduct some examination, so be ready, something like that, you can make the announcement. So here I want to create a discussion forum, and then even you can also create chat window. All those things can be done here. Now I want to add my course plan here in topic 1. So to change this topic 1 heading, what you do is you press this edit topic name. After that you will get this window. So I'm just typing it as course plan. Once you are done with this, just press enter button in your keypad. So I'm pressing enter. So course plan is added here. Now I want to upload a PDF file, PDF or Word file, that is nothing but my course plan. So to do that, click add an activity or resource. You will get this dialog box. So these are the various options available in Moodle. So you go down here, you have a option called file. You click file, and then you click add. Now you can give some name to this file. So I'm just typing it as course plan. If you want to describe anything about this file, you can also write the description, and then you can simply drag and drop the file here, or you can click this option, that is upload option, add, upload a file, choose file. My file is available in D drive, subjects. Analytics for print. So here is my HR analytics course plan. So I just uploaded this, upload this file. So now I have uploaded this file here, and then click save and return to course. So this is the way how you can add the resources here. Now I want to add a PPT or maybe some PDF file as a session 1 topic. So to create the session wise plan, or maybe to create a session wise content, what you do is you just follow your course plan. This is the course plan which I have created for this course. My session 1 is introduction to the course. I just copy paste this introduction to the course, press enter. For this session 1 introduction to the course, I don't want to keep or add any of the resources because I'm going to explain something about my course plan only. Still, if you want to add something in this option as a prerequisite or maybe pre-reading, you can click add an activity or resource, and then you can upload something. So now I want to share one of the resources from YouTube. So I'll go to YouTube, and then I'll try to locate that resource. So there is a video coming from Google, that is on People Analytics in Google by Prasad Sethi. So I want to refer this particular
session
video
at launch.
I want to ask my students to view this particular video before they come to the first class, so that they will get some idea about how Google is using HR analytics or people analytics. So I'll copy this and then I can go back there and then I can add it. I'll show you how to add this YouTube resource here. You click add an activity or resource, and then here you have different options. One is URL. Simply you can copy paste the URL link of the video. You can use page. I'm going to use this URL option and then click add, and then here you'll be able to get the excellent URL link of the file. Just paste that URL link here, and then you can give some names: YouTube video resource, or you can give the entire title here: HR Meet Science at Google by Prasad Shetty. And then you can also give the you just right click and then click copy embed code, so that this particular video will be visible in the home page itself. You press this downward arrow button and then you press this HTML option. You copy paste the embedded code of this video. Again you press this so that this video will be visible like this, and then you check display description on course page and then click save and return to course. Now your students will be able to watch the video from their window itself. Now if you want to check how this particular window is visible to your students, you can also switch your role from faculty to student. So as a student I want to see this how it is looking. So this is the way how your students will be able to see this window, and I'm just pressing.
Hello. Good
itself. So this is a way as a student I can watch this. So this is a way how you can populate this. So I'll go back to faculty mode, return to my normal role. So I'm back to the faculty role. Turn editing on. Now I want to add one more resource here for the next session. So I'll go to the next session. Session 2 is on this. I'll go here, edit, copy paste, press enter. Session 2 is on this topic. So let me check the required readings. So one of the reading is from this particular web page. So I'll copy paste this. Now I'll share the web page here. So add an activity or resource. Either you can share the URL or you can share the page. So I'll click page and then add. Now I'll copy paste the name of this page, and then here you can copy paste the page content. There are multiple ways are available how you can copy paste the page content. So I'll show you how to do that. So this is a site address. So I want to ask my students to go through this page before they come to the class. So let me open this page in another tab. I got it. Now if you want to insert this particular page as a embedded option, you just right click and then view page source. You will get the entire HTML code of this page. Control E, Control C, go back to this page and then press down arrow and then HTML. Just copy paste the HTML codes of this page and then again click this HTML, so that here itself the students will be able to see the content. So this is the way how you can populate the web page. And then if you want to write any description, you can write it here. If you don't want to keep anything, you just keep and then save and return to course. Now this particular page will be, once they click this in the student window, I'll show you how it will look like in student window. Switch role to student. So now I'm clicking this page. So it is opening the entire page in the Moodle site itself. There's a way how you can see the page content in your Moodle site itself. or even simply you can share the URL link of this page. Anything is fine. I'll go to the faculty mode now. Return to normal role. Turn editing on. Now I want to share one of the PDF file. So here the limitation of this particular Moodle site is you can share only 100 MB of, you can consume only 100 megabytes of size. So my kind advice is you create a new Google Drive folder in your Gmail, or you use OneDrive or maybe any of the cloud platform. You keep whatever maybe the materials you want to send it to your students in that Google Drive folder, and then simply you just copy paste the link of those files in your Moodle site. Through that way you can share the materials to your students. So in the session 2, let me check, are there any other papers, references? So there is a reference coming from MIT Sloan Management Review Journal. So I'll try to open this paper. Suppose if this paper is freely available to the public, means simply you can open that paper. Yeah, this paper is coming from this particular site. You can also download it and then you can share it. But instead of that, what you can do is you can share the URL link of this particular paper if it is freely available to the students. So it's a best way. So I'm just copying this and then go back here, add an activity or resource. Now I'll use URL, add. Here you copy paste the URL link of that page, and then the title of this citation is, you can create the citation of this paper and then you can paste it there. I'll go to Google Scholar to generate the full citation of this paper. Paste it. So this is the citation of this paper. Come back to your page, paste it here, and then save and return to course. Now this is how it will look like. So once they click this link, automatically it will open a new tab in another window, and then if they click this particular link, they'll be able to go to the home page of this MIT Sloan Management Review. So this is a way how they can access the paper. So this paper is not freely available to the public. Now another way of sharing this particular resource is, if this paper is freely coming from any one of the source, you just this is coming freely coming, you just copy this link, copy link address, and then go back here, edit this, edit settings, and then in the place of this URL link, in the place of this URL link, you paste this link, paste this link, and then save and return to course. Now as a student, if they click this particular link, they'll be able to open the PDF file in their window. Yeah, by clicking this, they'll be able to download this particular file into their local drive, because this is coming from one of the free source. So that's the reason I'm just sharing the paper, exact citation of the paper, paper downloadable link into this Moodle page. Also, I'm giving this full citation of this paper with the help of university access. They can also access this. Now let me check the other things. Already have shared this video. Now I need to share this particular paper. Let me check whether this paper is freely available or not. I'll go back to Google Scholar, copy paste. So this paper is coming from Science Direct. I don't know whether they have the access. I don't have this access. Yeah, I do have the access, but anyway, I'll share the home page of home page link of this reference to my students. Add an activity or resource, URL, add, copy paste the URL link here, copy paste the URL link here, and then you try to generate the full citation of this paper. copy paste here so that they will be able to understand what is the citation of this paper. Now if they go to their student window, they will be able to see this. Once they click this, it will open a new tab. So directly it will direct them to the web page where they can download this particular paper. So this is a way how you can share web links, web link of the reference as well as web page reference. And then to share any one of the PPT or PDF, I'll show you how to share it with the help of Google Drive. So here itself I want to share the course introduction PPT. So before that, let me create a Google Drive folder in my Gmail. So if you log into your Gmail account, you will be able to create a Google Drive folder here. Just go there and then you click Google Apps and then try to locate Drive and then create a new folder here. So I'm creating a new folder. So whatever may be the content you want to share, whether it is a document file or maybe PDF file, everything can be shared from this particular source. So click new folder, Moodle sample site, create. So now I'll drag my PPT into this folder. My PPT is available in my subject folder. So just drag this here, or if you want to upload the file, you can also right click here and then you can click upload files and then you can locate the file, whatever may be the file you want to share. So before you share anything from your drive, try to make sure that you are not giving editing rights to the students or public. If you give editing rights to the public or students, they can do anything in your Google Drive folder, like they can remove the file or they can add anything. So what you do is just click this option and then click share. You will be able to get this window. So here you can change the rights. Anyone with the link can view. If you give editor, they can do anything with the help of this particular link. So I don't want to give editor rights, so I'm giving only viewing rights. Copy this link, done. If you share this particular folder, by clicking that folder link, they'll be able to access whatever may be the content which you are going to upload it into this folder. Instead, you right click this and then you can also make sure whether you are not giving editing rights. Yes, this is not editing rights. Now you copy this link, and then to copy the link, you right click on the file, click get shareable link. Come back to the course page. Here I want to add my PPT. Click URL. Click this. If you upload your PPT here, that will consume some space. That's the reason I'm just keeping everything in my Google Drive folder. Introduction to HRA PPT. Here you paste the link of that Google Drive file. And then click save and return to course. Now student can access this particular PPT from their Moodle site. So I'm just clicking this. Now they'll be able to open this PPT file here. So this is the way how you can share the links to your students. Now there are other options also available. I'll add one more session here. So I want to add this session 3. Press enter and then add an activity or resource. If you want to share the file, PDF file or maybe PPT or any of the files directly to your students, you can use this file option. Suppose if you use this folder, what will happen is whatever may be the files are stored in that particular folder, that can be visible to your students. Now I'm clicking folder option. I'll create a new folder here. So I want to share a couple of references. For example, I want to share some data sets. I'm just creating a folder called data sets. Here you can move all the data sets or maybe whatever may be the files you want to send it to your students. For example, I'm just going back to my Moodle. Purposefully, I'm just creating one more file here. Copy, paste, paste. Purposefully, I just created three files here just for this demonstration purpose. I'm just dragging everything into this box. So now I have uploaded three files here. So this is the way how you can upload the files here. And then click save and return to course. This is how it will look like in your student window. For example, I'll switch my role to student from faculty student. So if they access your course content, so they'll be able to see this folder. So basically here, if they click this data sets, whatever may be the files uploaded into this data set folder, everything will be visible to the students. Either by clicking this download folder, they can download the entire folder, or simply they can click each and every files and then they'll be able to download it. So these are the ways how you can share different types of resources to your students through Moodle. And then I'll show you some more things. I'm just going to the HRA homepage and then turn editing on. Now what you do is here you can also click add an activity or resource. If you see here, you have this file option. Directly you can upload the file. If you have some book chapter and all, you can also upload the book chapter. That is also possible. So I'm just clicking book, add. If you have any open textbook page, you can also add it here simply by copy pasting the HTML code of that particular book page. That is possible. So for that reason, you can use this book page. Even you can also copy paste the URL link of that particular PDF file. Suppose if that is saved in your Google Drive folder, anything you can do. So I don't have any book content now, so I'm not showing this. So this is the way how you can add some of the resources. So URL page is over, folder, file, and then book is also over. So this is the way how you can share the materials to your students. So in the next video, I'll show you some of the other features available in Moodle Cloud Platform. Thank you.